Good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome to Embrace Hope International 5613, Rockfish Road in the great town of Hope Mills. I want to welcome you in the house this morning.
Yes,
welcome Lord. You into the atmosphere of the Lord that we know is a Savior. Welcome your heart and everything that was preventing you from coming here. We bind it up right now in the name of Jesus that it will no longer hinder you anymore in your future. I just thank God for this atmosphere.
I thank God
for the church. I thank God because you are the church and you are like-minded people gathered in these four walls this morning, ready to glorify and magnify God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit and the things that He's able to do and already have done exceedingly and abundantly and above all that we may ask or think, according to the power already working inside of us. And so this morning, I want you to just relax and allow God to minister to you this morning. Allow the voice to come to you. He says, harden not your heart when you hear the sound of my voice, and allow God to move you in a direction that's going to shake you in the name of Jesus. So I just thank God for allowing us to be in this atmosphere, allowing us to be in His presence. And those that's trying to get here, Father, bind up the mechanical failure, move it out of their way, move the obstacles out of their way, so they're able to get here in peace in the name of Jesus. So just want to say welcome, welcome, welcome to Embrace Hope International. Those of you that's listening to us on the first time, on the internet, welcome to Embrace Hope International. Here, the only thing we love to do is just love on the Lord. We like to give you the uncut version. We don't want to give you that flower down version. We want to give you the uncut version. That way you make up your own mind how you want to flow. But you can say that you got the right word of God. So I just want to give God the praise this morning. If you would, please, go into prayer with me as we begin to move in a direction that's so sanctified by God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you this morning.
Yes,
God, I give you the praise, the glory, the honor.
Yes.
First of all, God, I want to say that you are God. And we're worshiping you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
And because of that, Lord God, thank you for who you are.
Thank you
for blessing us. Thank you for working it out, Lord. In the name of Jesus. And God, thank you for allowing us to be on the wake-up list this morning, God.
Yes,
as you brought us to this particular point in our life. You brought us here, Lord God, that we may now glorify you. And so, God, the things that we're about to do, justify us, God, that you may be glorified in the name of Jesus. So as we begin to move, God, sanctify our ears, Lord God, our ear gate, God, and whatever is going through, God, is going to be filtered. And it's not going to be a deceit, not going to be deception from Satan, but filter it now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Whatever is going into our eye gate, God, you said put nothing unholy before our eyes. And so as we begin to flow this morning, God, nothing unholy should begin to come through our own. That we're using our technical devices, God, let nothing pop up that's going to pull us in another direction. So I believe now, God, that you are an awesome God. You're an almighty God. This atmosphere is ready for you, Father. This atmosphere is sanctified by you. In the name of Jesus. And Satan, we give you 30 seconds to exit this building in the name of Jesus. As we send you back to the pits of hell for which you came. In the name of Jesus. Get out of here right now. This atmosphere is sanctified. God, come in now. Set yourself down and begin to realize this is your house. Come in, Lord Jesus. Cross your legs and realize you are at home now in the name of Jesus as we begin to worship you even more in the name of Jesus. So thank you, God, for what you've done in our life. Thank you, God, for what you're about to do in our lives. And thank you for the loved ones, God, that we're standing in the gap for this morning. We're standing in the gap for them, God, and they'll be able to be blessed by you in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
This do now, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Elder, come on, come on, come on. Let the Lord use you through song. Let him use you through song. Let the Lord use you. And as he begins to use you through song, thanks, just get into that word and let God mesmerize you. Let him work it out in the name of Jesus. He will. He will. I promise you he will. In the name of Jesus. So come on, come on, come on. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Lord.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Thank
you, Lord. Another brand new day that God has blessed us and spared
Thank
our lives.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Thank
yes,
you, Lord. Because I'm so glad that he spared our lives.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for this brand new day. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness, for your goodness to us, God. Because, Lord, we know that apart from you, we're nothing, Lord. We need you, God, in every situation, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
So go before us, Lord, in everything that we do and say, God.
Yes,
help us
Lord.
To stay on the right track, God.
Yes,
that we follow you and not ourselves, God.
Yes,
help us, Lord, to listen to the Spirit, Lord, and obey, Lord, your word. In Jesus' name. name we pray, Lord. Amen. Thank you, God. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, what a fellowship.
Ooh.
Oh, what a joy divine.
Ooh.
Every day I'm leaning on His everlasting arms. Oh, what a blessedness.
Ooh.
Oh, what a peace is mine.
Ooh.
Every day I'm leaning on His everlasting arms. Are you leaning? I'm leaning on Jesus. Are you leaning?
I'm leaning on Jesus.
Are you leaning? I'm leaning on Jesus. Are you leaning? I'm leaning on Jesus. Yes, I'm leaning. I'm leaning on Jesus. I'm leaning. I'm leaning on Jesus. His everlasting arms. Oh, what a fellowship.
Ooh.
Oh, what a joy divine.
Ooh.
Every day I'm leaning on His everlasting arms. Oh, what a blessedness.
Ooh.
Oh, what a peace is mine.
Ooh.
Every day I'm leaning on His everlasting arms. Are you
the dark
Bye. Thank you, Lord, for keeping our minds, God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, God, that you raised us up another day.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, God. With all what we got going on, God, everybody got something going on, but God is there.
Thank you, Lord.
He will answer. I don't mind waiting.
know he's gonna show up. He's gonna renew our strength. We're gonna mount up on wings of eagles, walk and not become weary, run and not become faint. We serve a God that's gonna be right there for us. So wait, I say, on the Lord. And be of good courage. Wait, I say, on the Lord. He will bless you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Elder, for such a smooth way of transitioning us to how the Lord is going to move us this morning and strengthen us like never before.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. First, in the way of announcements, the Women of Power is going to meet today, but we have the Women of Power. They're going to have a celebration next week.
Amen.
Amen. As we begin to love on our women in the house, we have Shaquita Davis from True Love Church International. She'll be here to bring that word to us as we begin to move like never before.
Thank you, Lord.
Saints, we serve a powerful God, and I just love him. As he begins to move on the women of this house, just next week, we'll have a celebration for the Women of Power. And also, this evening, after church service, the women are going to come together and plan a team, Women of Power, and finalize everything that makes sure that we're on track with where we're flowing in the name of Jesus. Listen, if you know it by memory or you have a program in front of you, let's stand. Let's say the confession of faith. If you don't know it, I'll say it out loud. I think you have it on the TV. If not, we'll go from there for the confession of faith. I know some of you, you know it by my heart, so that's good. And it goes this way. This is my church. My church gives me hope. God planted me here so I know I will grow. I am blessed and refreshed, pure and mature, faithful and grateful, healthy and wealthy. We are debt-free, the lender not the borrower, the head not the tail, above and not below. We walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. We pray diligently as we continue our quest. We are mighty soldiers under God's microscope, so it was mighty that his people hope. Praise the name of Jesus. I want to proclaim that over your life this morning. I want to proclaim it that God shall give you your hope. It shall be granted unto you as you begin to realize that this hope is your anchor in God as we begin to flow and transition. I want to reiterate from last week, as we establish, but this week I want to confirm in the name of Jesus. I want to establish, and I also want to confirm this week in the name of Jesus. Last week we established who was Jesus and how he got here, because we know that the book of John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. In the beginning was the Word, and just below that it says, and he was with God. And so today, we established who Jesus was, but today I want to confirm it. So if you would, please turn in your Bibles to the book of Colossians. Go to the book of Colossians, if you would, please. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Go to the book of Colossians. Go to the book of Colossians, if you would, please. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise the name of Jesus. This morning we have a visitor in the house. Good morning, good morning, good morning to you at this place. We just love on the Lord. We allow him to do what we expect him to do. We look forward for him to do his will and his purpose. So good morning here at Embrace Hope International. Just know that you're at home, and you can just allow the Holy Spirit to use you as he needs to, in the name of Jesus. So welcome, welcome, welcome to Embrace Amen. Hope International this morning. We give you the praise. We thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Go to the book of Colossians. Go to the book of Colossians. That's going to be where I'm going to finish in Colossians. But I got to walk you first through this procedure of confirming who Jesus is before we get to Colossians. And so as we begin to flow, I want you to understand that the God that sent me here this morning, he came for your purpose and he came for my purpose so that he could purpose this world. He came to establish the kingdom, this kingdom. He came to establish this kingdom. And so God had to send his son Jesus down to do it. And so that's why he said in the book of John, first chapter, in the beginning was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. The Word was with God. In the beginning was the Word. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you this morning, Father. I decrease as you increase right now in the name of Jesus. Father, use me to bring forth your Word, bring forth your purpose, and help me to preach it and explain it and teach it in a way that even a child is listening to be able to understand it. Father, I thank you right now for what you're about to do in this atmosphere. Thank you for everyone that's sitting here. Thank you for everyone that's listening and everyone trying to get here, Father. Find the obstacles, move them out of the way that they'll be able to get here and do it in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for what you're about to do in this house this morning. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Again, today we're going to talk about press the reset button. We talked about pressing that reset button last week. As that reset button, you know, I was trying to move towards, you know, back in the day when I was a young man, we had this tape recorder, this handheld tape recorder. It had cassette tapes in it, and I know some of y'all don't have a clue what I'm talking about, but it had cassette tapes in it. And with that, it had play, fast forward, rewind. And so today, what I wanted to talk about last week was we pressed the rewind button so that you can go back to the beginning of that cassette tape so you can listen to all your songs again. Well, today, last week, we pressed the reset button so we can go all the way back from when we first got saved. The purpose of us getting saved, why we got saved, and who we got saved towards. And so we talked about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We talked about how he came into the flesh. And then 1 John 1:14 tells us that that word that was with Jesus became flesh. And when that word that was with God became flesh, that name was called then Jesus Christ. Christo was his name. Christo, Christian, Christ. Christ, Jesus and Christ. Jesus means the anointed, and Christ means in his anointing. So you look at Jesus the Christ, you're looking at the anointed one and his anointing. That's what that meant. That's what that meant. So we began to move through the power of Jesus, through how Jesus began to give authority, how Jesus began to help us. But when we look at 1 John 5:4, don't go there. You can just look at it on the motor train because I'm going to be moving kind of quickly for you. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith, which is he who overcomes the world, but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. So we have to establish in our hearts, establish in our minds, that God sent Jesus, he made Jesus the Word, and then when Jesus came into the atmosphere, he became the living Word. He became the power that we needed in order to move like never before. But when he came into this world, when he got into this atmosphere, John 9:4 tells us, he said, I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. As long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world. And so as long as Jesus was in this world, he was the light of the world simply because the Word was made flesh. And when the Word was made flesh, it was position in this world, this atmosphere, so that you and I will be able to see who Jesus is. We'll be able to lay eyes on who Jesus is. In fact, we was able to lay eyes on the very Word of God. We was able to lay eyes on who God is. It is his only begotten Son. And so he tells us that. So we look at John 16:33 tells us, these things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world, you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome them. So as Jesus began to plot his path, we are confirming Jesus' purpose in this world. He says, these things I'm speaking unto you. So he has given us the Word of God. He has given us his Son, Jesus. And Jesus told us the things that I'm speaking of. He says, I've overcome the world. He said, but be of good cheer. You're going to go through some things, saints. Tribulation is going to happen. Condemnation is going to come before you, but you don't have to bow down to it. People are going to talk about you. People, let me help you now. You have a lot of people jealous of you. You have a lot of people that's in your circle jealous of you that you don't even realize that they are. But they're there because they can see some changes in you. They can see how things are moving towards you. They can see how God is blessing you. So they're going to hold on. They're going to hold on. Why? So everyone that's patting you on your back is not there for you. They're there to see where God is taking you. And as God begins to move you, then they're going to move with you. But look at Luke 9 and 56. As Jesus came into this world, his very purpose word, Luke 9 and 56 says, "For the Son of Man did not come to destroy man's life, but to save them." So now we know that God sent Jesus in this world to save you and I. Woo! Thank you, God. Because Satan wanted everything to do with destroying us. Because, let me back up now. Remember, Satan was in heaven with God. Satan wanted to take over the kingdom of God. God said, "Come on, man, I own this place. This is my house. How you going to take this?" But the Bible says he's seen Satan fall like lightning. So Satan can't beat God. He surely can't win against Jesus, so he's coming against the children of God. He's coming against the Son of Man. He's coming against you and I. And so with that, Jesus said, I came in this world to save us, to bless us, to keep us covered. But look at John 5 and 19 says, "And Jesus answered them, his disciples, and said to them, Most surely I say to you that the Son can do nothing of himself but what he sees the Father do. For whatever he does, the Son also does in like manner." But if you go to verse 21, it says, "For as the Father raises the dead and gives life to them, even so the Father gives life to them who he will." And so now he has established that. Jesus has established that. I can do nothing except it be from God. Saints, you and I can do nothing except it be from Jesus. Because we cannot get into the kingdom unless it comes from Jesus. Amen. Moving along. I just love the Lord today. Amen. And I thank you for it. John 17 and 4 tells us that I have glorified you on earth. I have finished the work which you have given me to do. And now, O Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before this world was. That is establishing to you right now that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God, and in the beginning was the Word. John 1 and 1. And the same one that says that he was with God. So this is Jesus establishing to you and I through the Bible word that he was with God. And now he's telling God, bring me back because I've done the work that you told me to do here. I'm ready to get back to heaven. I'm ready to enjoy heaven. I want to get away from this sinful nature of people here. I want to get back before where I used to be. Get me back, Lord. But I'm almost to Colossians because I had to establish this because I want you to see how we serve a God that sent Jesus to help you and I. But Philippians 2, 9 through 11 tells us that therefore God also has highly exalted him, giving him the name which is above all names, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and of those in heaven, and of those on earth, and of those on earth, and of those under the earth, and that every tongue shall confess that Jesus is the Lord to the glory of God the Father. This is why we say in Jesus' name. That's why we say in Jesus' name. So when you finish your prayer, you say in Jesus' name, then you say amen, which is me. And the Jesus' name, amen, simply means I agree. So you're saying the anointed one and his anointing, I agree with that. Oh, y'all hear me? The anointed one and his anointing, I agree with that. Why are you saying that, Pastor? Because Jesus means the anointed one. Christ means and his anointing. Amen simply means I agree. So you're saying the anointed one, his anointing, I agree. So that's why you say at the end of your prayer, I agree with what Jesus has established. I agree with what Jesus said. I agree with the purpose and the reason why he came down here. I agree with that. So that's why Philippians 2 and verse 5 tells us that let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. Oh, y'all follow me now. Y'all follow me now because I want to establish in you that the reason that you got saved were you knew the purpose of Jesus. You heard about Jesus. You said amen. But Philippians 2 and 5 says, let this mind that is in Christ Jesus be also in you. So Jesus said, the things that I've done, greater shall you do. Hey, I've raised the sick. I healed them. I raised the dead. I gave them back their lives. I put my hands over the blind, and it was able to see again. I put my hands over the ear, and it was able to hear again. You said, the things that I've done, greater shall you do. Then he got the disciples together at Luke 10 and 17. He told the disciples to go out. He says, go out, and I want you to compel the people to come to the house of the Lord, and I want you to talk to them. But the disciples came back. Luke 10 and 17 says, the disciples, the 70 returned with joy, saying, Lord, even the demons are subject in your name. So even the demons are subject to the name of Jesus. Wow. So if the demons are subject to the name of Jesus, then Luke 9, 1 and 2 tells us, you don't have that, Brother Barry, but Luke 9, 1 and 2 tells us that Jesus has given us the power and authority. The power to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. The authority to cast out demonic spirits that they had to flee from us. The things that Jesus done, he now has given you and I the authority to do the same thing. But in the midst of you operating under your authority, in the midst of you operating under the power that Jesus told you to have, in the midst of this, some of us feels like that we can't measure to where God is trying to take us. So we feel condemned. We feel like God is not helping us like I think he should. We feel like there's something missing inside of us, that if that piece of the puzzle was placed in us, we would compel ourselves, project ourselves to get to where God is trying to take us. But that's just the spirit of the Antichrist. That's just Satan, because Romans 12 and 2 tells us, and do not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So we have to make up our mind that, who am I going to believe? This demon that was kicked from heaven like lightning, or Jesus the Christ that came down and helped us? Now, before we begin to move, we're establishing, we've now confirmed who Jesus is. We now confirm that he came for us. We now confirm that whatever we're going through, our mind is going to be just like Jesus. I have confirmed to you through the word of God that Jesus loves us so much, that God loves us so much that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. I think I confirm that to you. And I confirm to you that you're going to go through some tribulations. You're going to go through some trials. You're going to go through some suffering. But be of good cheer, because our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ said, I'm going to be right there for you, with you, and through the situation that you're going through. But I want you to go to the book of Colossians that it was talking about earlier. Go to the book of Colossians. Go to the first chapter of the book of Colossians. As Paul began to talk, now Colossians, it was a place where people was believing strongly in Jesus Christ. Ephesians focused on the body, and but Colossians, the book of Colossians, the people were stronger believers in Christ. They focused on the head of God. They focused on the head. They focused on the church setting as they begin to move and understand who this Jesus is. But watch this. Colossians 1 and verse 9 says, for this reason, we also, since the day it was heard, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. This is a prayer that Paul prayed over the Colossians so that they would understand, Jesus, hear your prayers, but there's something inside of you that you're missing. There's something inside of you that you're not operating on, and there's something inside of you that needs to be exposed and gotten rid of. So that you be filled with the knowledge of his will. We have to be filled with the knowledge of his will. Lord, what is the will for my life? What is my purpose? Why am I here? What am I supposed to do? Where am I supposed to be? The Holy Spirit is going to lead and guide you, but he prayed that you be filled with the knowledge of his wisdom, of his will, and all wisdom and spiritual understanding. Spiritual understanding, knowing that if God be for me, who could be against me? The spiritual understanding is knowing that I died to my old self, and I've been reborn to my new self. The spiritual understanding that tells us in John 6 and 63, everything about the flesh is going to die, but everything about the spirit is going to live eternally. So God wants you and I, Jesus is looking forward to you and I, realizing that there is eternal living that we can undergo. Verse 10 says, Colossians 1 and verse 10 says, that you may have a walk worthy of the Lord, pleasing him, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. So now he's asking you, hey, do you have a walk worthy of the Lord and fully pleasing him? Being fruitful in every good work, increasing in the knowledge of him? Are we doing this on the daily? Because if you're not doing it on the daily, you are missing a step in your life where God, every day should be a learning experience. Every day should be filled with you trying to climb that ladder to get higher to God. Every day. That's why he says you should have a walk worthy of the Lord. Fussing at your co-worker, cussing them out, getting mad at your supervisor, want to choke your best friend because they didn't do what you thought they should do. Is that walking a life worthy of Jesus? Telling mama where she could get off because mama thinks she knows everything. Telling daddy what you're just not going to do no more because you're tired of him talking to you the way that he is. Is that a walk worthy of the Lord and pleasing him? And also, is that a walk of being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God? So the only way that you're going to be fruitful and increasing in the knowledge of God is you have to read his word. You have to read the Bible. I've been told that the Bible simply means basic instructions before leaving earth. But we got to read those instructions so that we would know what the will is. We would know what his purpose is. We would know what our reason is. Because God says, I will bless you. He said, I will work it out. I will give you a hot desire. And that's why some of us, we got to understand that we have to increase in the knowledge of God. Just opening the Bible on Sunday might make Bible study on Wednesday not going to read through the week. You may say a 2-minute prayer, Lord, thank you for waking me up, help me to make it through the day, and that's all you did for the whole week. You are missing out on where you should be and the power God is trying to give each and every one of us, because we woke up this morning, he closed us in our right mind. He gave us the power to realize our thought process. He has given us another reason and another step to become more like him. Come better than him and do the thing he has purposed us to do. That's why God sent Jesus Christ in this atmosphere so that we would see that greater is he that is in me than he that's in this world. Ephesians 3 and 20 says, now to him that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all that you may ask or think, according to the power already working inside of you. It's working inside of you because Jesus deposited that inside of us. As he deposited that inside of us, he says, now strengthen with all might, according to his glorious power, for all patience and long suffering with joy. So he's saying, strengthen yourself with all your might, according to his glorious power, for all patience and long suffering with joy. Saints, sometimes, based on the situation, based on the circumstances, based on what you keep encountering, it's hard to strengthen yourself. It's hard to say, okay, God, go ahead and do it, Lord. Sometimes we want to put our hands in the midst of that situation and fix it ourselves. So you're not strengthening yourself. You're weakening yourself to that deception and that the power that's coming against you. You're not strengthening you. You are strengthening what's coming against you. But God said, say that to me what I said already to you. Strengthen yourself with all your might. Sometimes it's hard to strengthen yourself through what you're going through. Sometimes it's hard to say, Lord, I know you got it. Lord, where you at, Lord? Okay, Lord, I'm going to have faith. I'm just going to believe in you. Sometimes it's hard to do that, saints, because that power of that thing that's coming against you sometimes is choking you. Sometimes it's choking the life out of you. You say, Lord, I believe you got this thing, Lord. I believe you got it. Okay, Lord. But then you wake up the next morning and you're faced with not only that, but you're faced with some other things that's popping up and coming. You say, Lord, how much strength do I have in order to get through this situation? Lord, how? And then you close your eyes and you say, okay, Lord, I hear what you say, but I'm going to give it back to you, God, because I thought that he was the one for me, but it seems like every time I turn around, something about this person is exposed, Lord. And what do I do now? Because I have too much embedded in this person. And I thought she was the one for me, but every time I turn around, something about her is being exposed. And so I've given her my all. I've given him my all. What do I do now, Father? Where do I go now? How do I stand now? This thing is becoming diminishing. And all my hope, Lord God, I've been hoping on you. God, I'm not hurting nobody. Lord, I'm doing the best I can. You see, what Satan wants you to do is, when you become in a hard place, when you become in a place that doesn't look like you can get out of, he wants you to give your resume back to God. He wants you to tell God, Lord, I did all I can do. Lord, I've been going to church. I've been paying my tithes. I've been doing the best I know how. See, that's your resume. But that has nothing to do with the power that lies inside of you. Woo! Say it again, Pastor. Lord, I've been going to church. I've been paying my tithes. I ain't stealing from nobody. I'm not beating up nobody. I'm doing the best I can. Lord, I haven't cursed in a couple days, my Father. I'm trying to do my will. What you have just said to God, Satan's laughing at, because he said, that's all he is. Doing good. That's all she is. She ain't cuss. Okay. I'm gonna make her cuss. Okay. That's all she is. But you see, you got to say, Lord, your word says, I have power in you. Your word says, I can speak things that be not the Lord's word. Your word says, I can cast out demonic spirits. Your word says, I can lay hands on the sick. They shall recover. So, God, in the power of you, in the dominion that I have over the situation that's coming against me, I cast it out. I send it back to the pits of hell for which it came. God can care less about your resume. He wants to know if you understand through the wisdom of him. Do you understand through the knowledge of him who you really are?
Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Who are you? You have dunamis power with you. Greater is he that's already in you than he that's in the world. Stop giving God your resume. He can care less, because he can come back at you to say, Lord, I've been doing the best I can. Have you? Have you read my word today? No, Lord. Have you prayed for somebody today? No, Lord. And you're not doing the best you can. You see, when we give God our resume, he can always come back and beat that resume up. But when you say, God, I gave you my all. I prayed today. I woke up with you on my mind. I gave you everything that I have. Now, God, go before me and make the crooked paths straight. Give me your power. Strengthen me with your might. And everyone that comes before me today, God, give me the wisdom. Give me the understanding. And give me the ability to walk away from that that's being deceitful. Walk away from that that's trying to purposely help me. But give me the power. Give me the wisdom. Give me the understanding that when it's time for me to lay hands on them, I shall. When it's time for me to cast out that demon that's coming against me, hold up now. God said in Luke 9:1-2, I gave you the authority to cast them out. So when that person is coming against you, he's going to give you what is called discernment of spirit. You see what's in this person. You know what's coming against them, and you have discernment of spirit. You can begin to say, Satan, I see who you are. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, evil wickedness in heavenly places. If Satan can steal your joy, you know when you woke up and when you finished that prayer, you got yourself together, you ride to work singing your Christian song, you felt good. Satan hates the fact that you feel good. Woo! He hates the fact that you feel full of joy, especially after you don't talk to your God. Who are you to think that you can talk to Jesus and feel good about it today? You haven't even got to your desk. Here he comes. You haven't even gotten to the door of the place. Here they come. You haven't even gotten out of your car good. But here comes this text across the phone that's gotten you to the point where you say, good gracious, not today. Oh my God. He had to steal your joy. He had to take it from you. But then you say, oh God, here I go again. Not again. But you say, today this thing stops with me. Today this thing will no longer continue to haunt me. It will no longer continue to hurt me. That's why the Bible says, strengthen yourself with all your might. You can't strengthen you, but the word of God is strengthen you. So he began to quote those scriptures. He began to tell Satan what he can't do. Then watch this, verse 12 says, now giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to partake of the inheritance of the saints in the light. So now you are in the light of God. You're in the light of Jesus. You're in the light. And when the light is shined upon you, it's time for you to glow. It's time for you to realize, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Just because you met your limitation doesn't mean I have. Just because you received your accolades at the level that you're at doesn't mean I have. Because I have not yet arrived to the very abilities that I have. Because I am steadily stepping up this ladder. Every step goes higher and higher. And every step that I get on is going to bring stronger demonic attack. Because the higher I get, the more I'm going to be a threat to the kingdom of Satan. And the more that I'm a threat to the kingdom of Satan, Satan has to send his arsenal out to stop me. He has to send his arsenal out to stop me. Well, what are you talking about, Pastor? Prove that. When Elisha, he had 450 prophets. And these prophets would get together and they would call down their God and he would not show. He would not show. They would cut themselves with whatever. They would cut themselves with rocks, sweats, whatever. And that God never showed. But he got some food and water and he put it around the little idol that they made. He called down heaven. And the Bible says fire came down from heaven and consumed what Elijah had prayed over. So Elijah showed all these people, I have power. I can do what God says I can do. I have power. But just because he had the power didn't mean he tried to stay in the power. Because Jezebel told him, the things that you've done to my prophets, because he had all of guilt. He said, the thing that you've done to my prophets, because he got rid of Satan plan. The thing that you've done to my prophet, he said, because I got rid of everything that Satan was trying to do to me. The things that you said to my prophet, be it unto me, if today, tomorrow, the same time, I'm going to do the same thing to you. You see, he's already showed the power of God. He's already showed that if I pray to God, things are going to work on my behalf. He already showed that I pray to God, and he showed a miracle by bringing lightning from heaven and begin to consume these sacrifices that I made, that they made, that I made, and they was already ready to see. Watch this. When the fire came down from heaven and consumed the sacrifice, the people was able to see it. When God began to bless you, the people are going to be able to see it. The people are going to be able to say, how did she get that when I know what she was going through? How did he maintain that when I know what he was going through? But getting back to Elijah. When Jezebel, that demon, told him that she was going to kill him, he gets up and he runs. The Bible said he ran and got up under this cherubim tree. And when he got up under the tree, Jesus asked him, he says, Elijah, why are you here? Why are you here? My question to you this morning, saints, in your mind, why are you here? I'm not talking about embrace hope international. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm deeper than that. But why are you where you are right now in the power of your mind to think that the God that blessed you 2 years ago, the God that brought you out 1 year ago, that situation that you didn't think was going to happen, it happened, but God brought you out of it just last week. Why now are you running to a place because new situations happen? You think that the God that saved you then won't protect you now. What brought you here? Boy, y'all got quiet on me up in here. But I want to know what brought you here. Because God is going to bless you. He is going to strengthen you. Watch this. Verse 13 says, he has delivered us from the power of darkness, translated us into the kingdom of the Son of his love. So he has delivered us from darkness. He's already delivered us from darkness. When you came and said, Lord, I want you to save me, Jesus is already the purpose in this world. If you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. So So when you say, God save me, it's at that point, like that, he said he was delivered from the power of darkness, translated into his kingdom of the Son. And at home we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin. Satan wants you to think that you're nobody. That your God doesn't care about you. That he has left you. He don't want nothing to do with you. And some of us are confessing just that. God, how you won't bless me? God, can't you see what I'm going through? God, why are you leaving me like this? God, I'm struggling now. I just need your help. But God says, I know everything about you. Hear me when I say this, saints. Hear me when I say this. Hear me when I say this. It was written. He said, my people are saying what they have, but my people are not saying what they want. My people are saying what they have, but my people not saying what they want, because if they see what they want, they can have that. Oh, y'all, I know we're going this side. My people are saying what they have. Lord, my car is doing this, and my house is doing this, and my rent is due, and that's due. We say what we have. But God said, if you say what you want, according to John 15 and verse 7, if you abide in me and my word remain in you, I'll give you your heart desire. So he said, if you say what you want and speak what you want, you can have your desire, because I've already given you that authority according to John 15 and verse 7. So let's stop saying what we have and let's start speaking what we truly want and believe in what we ask God for, because he has given us that power to do so. Give it to you now. But he says, he is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation, but by him all things was created that are in heaven, that are on earth, visible, invisible, whether throne or dominion, or principality or power, all things was created through him, for him, and he is before all things, and in him all things exist. Good God Almighty. If you didn't know, now you know. If you didn't know, now you know who you're serving. Everything belongs to your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm almost there, saints. I'm almost there. Look at verse 22. In a body of his flesh through death to present you holy and blameless, irreproachable in his sight. If indeed you continue in faith, grounded and steadfast, and are not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which you heard, which was preached to every creation under heaven, of which I, Paul, became a minister. Look at 26. That mystery which had been hidden from ages, from generations, but now have been revealed to the saints. To them God willed to make known what are the riches of the glory of his ministry, this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we preach, one and every man, teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ. To this end, I also labor, striving according to his work, working with works in us mightily. So my job today is to confirm to you who you're serving. Wow. Through his word, I have confirmed to you that he cares about you. I'm going to close my Bible. I have confirmed to you that he loves you. I have confirmed to you that he will be right there for you in the midst of your trials, your tribulations, your suffering. He will be right there for you. I have confirmed to you that the God that you serve loves you. And God loves you that he sent his only begotten son down here so you and I will have an example of, if God be for us, who can be against us? And so, saints, that matter what you're going through, stay hopeful, stay grounded, stay rooted and grounded in the word of God. That matter who has left you, well, Lord, I thought she was going to be here forever, but you took him from me. Stay rooted and grounded in God. Lord, I thought he was going to be here. Stay rooted and grounded in God. I know it hurts. I know it's coming against you from a negative standpoint, but you have to remember this. Each and every one of us one day are going to leave here. Every man is appointed once to die and once to be judged. But God said, I will help you. He said, I will protect you. I will keep you. He said, watch this. When God said all that, he said, I'm going to send my son down to prove to you. Because hear me, sons, hear me well. Jesus said in the Old Testament, he said, I hate that I made man. He said, I hate that I made man. Because we as men started acting just like that demon that he kicked out of heaven. He said, I hate the fact that I made man. 430 years went by before Jesus said a word. Oh, my God. I'm glad I wasn't living back then. But thank the Lord I'm living right now. And I know he was saying the same thing. So he came in. Now, hear me now. The first part of Matthew is still the Old Testament because Jesus was still there. So when Jesus died on the cross and he became back with God, now the New Testament began to happen. He says, when I leave here, I'm going to leave you another spirit. Because I can't be in Arizona, California, Wisconsin, North Carolina, South Carolina, all at one time because I'm a human. But when I leave here, I'm going to leave this spirit. This spirit is going to be holy because it's only going to do the things that the same purpose that I came, the same thing that God sent me down here to do. This spirit, this holiness about this spirit is going to do the same thing. Its purpose is the same thing I was doing is leading you. The same thing I was doing is guiding you. Its purpose is that. And so we're going to call this spirit the Holy Spirit because that Holy Spirit is there to lead and guide. And I know old school call it the Holy Ghost, but it's called the Holy Spirit as God says, I'm going to leave you a comforter. Today, saints, that comforter is there to lead and guide you, regardless of the way you are, the same way Jesus did. It'll go before you. It'll make crooked places straight. He says, don't go through that broad gate, because broad is it leads to destruction. Go through that narrow gate, which is going to cost you something to get through there. It's going to cost you something. It's going to cost you something. You got to stop that pleasure that you're doing. It's going to cost you something. You got to stop that thing that you're doing at home in your own house, doing what you think is right to do because nobody's looking at you. It costs you something. You got to quit it. That thought process that you have about her, or that thought process that you have about him, you got to let it go. It's going to cost you something to go through that narrow gate. Anybody can go through the broad gate, but it's going to cost you something to go through that narrow gate. He told Elijah, why are you here? So in your mind this morning, saints, what brought you here? What have you feeling like you're feeling? What have you questioning whether or not you're going to get through it? What have you questioning that this is the right thing for me? What have you questioned? What got you thinking that, Lord, why you take them? What got you here? What has you here? You and me have the power to change that situation. Woo! We have the power to change that situation. And if you operate in the power of God, of Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit, you are a new creature. Behold, all things have washed away. And there's a power in you. Closing and closing and closing. There is a power in you. There is a strength in you. There is an anointing in you. And every time you get to the point of releasing it and bringing it up out of your belly, because the Bible says, from your belly shall flow rivers of living water. So as this water begins to come up and bubble out of your heart, and whatever is in the man's heart is coming out of his mouth. So whatsoever a man thinketh, so is he. You're not thinking that you're a nobody. You're not thinking that you are a riser. You're not thinking that you're prosperous. Your heart is telling you you are prosperous, but your mouth is telling you some other thing. So now, every time it gets to the point where it's ready to come up, you're feeling good, you're feeling changed, you feel like I'm ready to do what I know I'm perfect. purpose to do. Here come your mouth speaking against what God has said about you. Here comes your mouth beginning to speak condemnation and damnation over what God has placed in your heart. It's in your heart that God has given you wisdom. It's in your heart that God has given you love. It's in your heart because your mind can change at the drop of a dime. That's why he said we have to renew our minds. So renew your mind and look into your heart and say, okay, body, you shall line up in the name of Jesus. Lay hands on your own head and command it to line up to the power of God, to the power of Jesus, to the power of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Command it to do that, and when you begin to command, you're going to begin to release in you. And when you begin to release this dormant anointing inside of you, when you begin to release that thing, Satan has to back up off of you because he now knows you know who you are.
Yes, Lord.
You know who you are.
Yes.
So he can bring a circumstance to you. You know, this is just another opportunity for me to strengthen my faith.
Amen.
Oh, he don't like that. He brought a strong situation to you. No weapon formed against me shall be able to prosper. And every word, every tongue that rises up against me shall be condemned. Satan, where you at now? What you going to do with me now? Oh, Lord, I'm falling apart. Now, you're not falling apart no more. You are being strong. He says, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of God. Don't listen to me. Listen to me as I close. Listen to me as I close. No man can ride your back unless you bend it. And Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
No man can ride your back unless you bend it. So you stand up and have to realize I'm a woman of God. I'm a child of God. I have to bend your shenanigans. I'm stronger than that. Come on, Usher. Come on, Usher. Somebody get me. Somebody get me. I'm stronger than that. No man can ride your back unless you bend it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah. We're going to move forward into communion as we... steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of him. Be ye steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of him. We are abounding, saints. We are abounding. We are abounding. Nothing by no means shall be able to hurt you, because you serve a God is standing with you. So now we have established and confirmed who Jesus is, the power that he's given us, and the anointing that's embedded inside of us. Saints, you haven't seen the best of you yet. You have not seen the best of you yet. Doesn't matter how much money you have, doesn't matter the car you drive or where you live in, you have not seen the best of you yet. God is ready to give you more. He's ready to give you more. That's why he says moving in knowledge of God daily. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You good? All right. So Jesus got his disciples together, and he says, in 3 days, I'm going to kill the body, and then I'm going to raise it up again. They're like, what in the world? What in the world are you saying, Lord? He said, in 3 days, I'm going to kill the body, and then I'm going to raise you up again. He had to explain to them that I have to die first in order that you all may live again. Praise the name of Jesus. So at that last table of eating, he brought some bread. He broke it. He says, before I leave, take, eat this. This represents my body. As often as you do it in remembrance of me. So he ate it. He took some wine, poured it in a vase. He said, this is going to represent my blood. He said, drink all of it. As often as you do it in remembrance of me. Saints, taking communion is one of the most sacred things that you can do in the house of the Lord. So my advice to you, when you're home sometimes, you just want to take some bread, you can just use water. You can take communion that way and give that back to God. And watch this. If you fast and you pray and then you add communion in there with it, oh my goodness, power beyond measure is going to, thank you, it's going to begin to happen towards you and for you, because you're operating under the kingdom of God and you're doing the things that he has already given us to do. In the name of Jesus. And why I still have you standing. I want to do an altar call, but I want you to stand where you are. While you're standing. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for who you are, for what you've done. I thank you that your word, oh my God, your word, God. Your word shall last forever. This word, this world shall pass away before your word does. And so because of that, God, I thank you for the word that went forth, and we confirm who you are. We confirm the power that you have. We confirm the power that you've given unto us. Now help us, Lord God, to walk in the power of you. Walk into the confirmation of what we heard today. Help us, Lord God, that whatever situation and circumstances rear its head, God, we're not going to bend to it, because our back is no longer bent, God. We're standing straight up now, and we can look straight into his eyes and make him understand, if Jesus didn't bow to Satan, neither should we, because we were birthed in his image. And because of it, God, I give you the praise. And so everyone that's listening to the sound of my voice this morning, God, touch them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Everything about them is not of you. I cast it out of here right now in the name of Jesus. Everything that's trying to come against them, Father, I bind it up right now. Send it back to the pits of hell. For your word tells in Matthew 18:18, whatsoever I bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatsoever I loose on earth is loose in heaven. Your word tells us in Mark 9:23, if we could just believe, all things are possible to us if we could just believe. So we believe it in the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We believe that he rose with all power. We believe that he's given us the authority to cast out demonic spirits. We believe that we can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. We believe that we have the power beyond measure to do the same things. The greater is he that is in us than he that's in this world. Father, we're standing on that belief this morning. We're looking for deliverance from you this morning. We're looking for a change, God, this morning. Those that heard this word, God, they shall feel a change about the mindset in the name of Jesus. So thank you now, God, for what you've done. Let this day, God, be confirmation to them. As they begin to go and purchase their food, Lord, somebody's going to pay for that for them. They begin to go and get their gas. Somebody's going to pay for it for them. God, show yourself to them today to show them that this wasn't just a regular meeting. This was a consecration. And because of it, God, I give you the spirit. I give you the power. I give you the glory that you would place upon us in the name of Jesus. So thank you, God, for what you've done. Thank you, God, for who you are. And thank you, God, for how you're going to continue to bless us in the name of Jesus. Lord, I give you the praise. I give you the glory and the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you now, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Be mindful that right after service, women of power is going to have a meeting. In the name of Jesus. As we begin to flow with next week, itinerary. Praise the name. Praise his name. Praise his name. Now, before we move to closing, does anyone have a quick testimony they want to say? They want to just alert us to let us know what God has done for them? You have the floor. Father, we thank you.
Amen.
Thank you. My sister, I thank God that you stood and said that, because a lot of us have testimonies we don't want to tell. But God said, if you deny me before men, I will deny you before Father. So thank you. See, Satan don't want you to stand up and say nothing good. Because who are you to say something good? But because you are living today, that's something good. So we just give God the praise for you. We just give him noteworthy praise this morning. That we serve an awesome God. And we don't want him to deny us for no reason. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Will there be another before we close?
Hey, you forgot offering.
Oh. Actually, ain't for the money. I'm going to give you the word and let you do what God do, but I can't slight you for getting your blessing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. Thank you. I don't want to mess up nobody's blessing. Okay. I'll give you mine. Come back. I got to do another part. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Amen, amen, amen.
Yes.
How
are
you?
Be given unto you. Press down, shaking together, running all the truth. Want the Lord Jesus.
Want the Lord Jesus.
Want him to be unto your good.
That he said, give with a generous heart. Be a cheerful giver. Because what you cheerfully give, he said, I will restore in the name of Jesus. So, Father, I thank you for who you are. I thank you for your word. It shall not go out void, but it will do what it was purposed to do. So finances has gone, Lord, to build this kingdom of yours in the name of Jesus. And so as this finances has gone forth, Father, everyone that placed in the basket, I ask that you bless them. Everyone that wanted to place and didn't have, begin to open up avenues that they will have on the next occasion. So we give you praise, honor, and glory in the name of Jesus. Help us, Lord God, to become financially stable in the name of Jesus. God, let me remind you of this. You said to Peter, you said, Peter, I want you to go to the water, cast your hook, catch that fish. And when you bring that fish to you, open its mouth, take that piece of money out and go pay our bills. My taxes and yours. You said, unless we offend them. So, Father, we don't want to offend no one else that we owe, no creditor that we owe, no bill that we have. We don't want to offend them. So, Father, you made a miracle for you. I'm asking you now, God, to make a miracle for your people, that they shall receive a blessing like never before. As I stand on this altar, Lord God, and quote your words that you placed in my mouth, I'm asking you now, God, to stand on your word. Open up avenues for your people to receive a financial blessing. And when they receive it, Lord God, they will not go in another direction, but run closer to you. That they will do what you say to do with their finances. They will begin to bring their tithing in with their finances, God. They will begin now to move with you. Not allow their money to be their God, but you stay their God. And so, God, I'm asking you now to bless your people's finances mightily right now in the name of Jesus. That they will get rid of that yoke that has them so bound. Do it now, Father, as I stand here on this altar and I'm raising it up to you. Do it now, Father. I thank you for what you're about to do to your people. That when I talk to them again, Lord God, they're going to say, this miracle happened. This financial blessing happened. This came through my mailbox, Pastor. I did it. Thank you. And Pastor, I did it on faith. God, I thank you for it. I thank you for it right now. This is all of the blessings that we ask. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 God, I thank you. Thank we serve a God that truly cares about what we're going through. He cares about what we're going through. We have to make the most of every opportunity to prove to him that we thank him for caring about what we're going through in the name of Jesus. One last request. Anyone has a testimony before we go? 12:20. No one? Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you. I thank you for who you are, for what you've done. Father, I thank you that your mercy endured forever. Father, we're standing here now on this podium, and we're going to call some names, Lord, and I want you to look about those names, God. There's sickness is happening. There's death occurring in the name of Jesus, Father. There's one that's in need in the name of Jesus. But as I read this list of names out, Father, I know, Lord God, that these people need a home. God, send them through these doors in the name of Jesus that I'm praying over them, but bring them to fruition and prove that the power alone and coming together in the midst of assembly. So as I pray for them, Lord God, bring them through the door so they can hear it in person. In the name of Jesus. Father, I know you're powerful and I know who you are. So Lord, I ask you right now to look at the Highsmith family, Father. They are experiencing death. But I know, Lord God, that you're going to help them through this hardship. You're going to help them, God, with whatever they're going through in the name of Jesus. Look at the Owens family, Father. Begin to move on that family, Father. I don't know what their need is. I don't know what they're going through. But I do know that you're a God that cares. You're a God that's going to protect. Look at Patricia and Tony, Father. They're going through sickness. But right now, God, by your stripes, God, they're healed. Strengthen them, God. Strengthen them now. In the name of Jesus. Michelle, Andrea, Jolene, Norman Murphy family, Rashida family. Help them, Lord. Roy, Purdy, Mike, Dora, Stella, Willa, Ollie Jr. Shaw. Begin to bless them, Lord. God, you had Brother Purdy in the house last week. God, you got him looking good. And I ask you right now, God, to restore everything about that young man. In the name of Jesus. You said you was going to bless him, God. We're standing on that blessing in the name of Jesus. We thank you for Brother Purdy. We thank you for Brother Roy. We thank you for how you're going to bless Sister Dora, Lord. How you told her just last week that it's time for her to begin to speak boldly your word. You said that even time in this house shall be made for her to come and speak your word. So thank you right now for what you're doing with brother, with Sister Dorothy, in the name of Jesus. Isabella and Leonard Kerr, Rochelle and family, Angela and Elisa, they're sick, God. Bless them. Latrice, she has cancer. Now I know, Lord God, what the doctor said, and I know what the MRI said, and I know what the screening says, but I also know what you said. You said that by your stripes she's healed. So I'm standing on it right now, Father. That cancer is, yes, it's been spoken. But your word that she's healed also has been spoken. So I want to hear, Lord God, that by your stripes she's healed. I'm calling out Latrice's name on this altar right now because I believe, God, that you can heal her. And I'm thanking you now, God, that cancer be sent back to the pits of hell from which it came in the name of Jesus. Maxine, Frank, and Eloise. Jocelyn and son, Doris Johnson family, Talicia Smith family, Ronnie, Marie, Joel, Odell, Jean, Linda, Sheila, Beatty, sickness, Kay, sickness, Alisa, Spell family, sickness. In the name of Jesus, Sandra Armstrong, we want to pray for her right now, Father. People are taking advantage of this woman. People are doing things to her like never before. But I command right now the power of strength of mind. Come over, Sister Armstrong, right now. In the name of Jesus, Father. Bind up the arrow that's coming against Sister Armstrong, God. And begin to take the scales over her eyes. That she's able to see things she's never seen before. That she's able to hear things she's never heard before. I command now, God, that you go where Sister Armstrong is right now. And begin to bless her like never before. God, I want to hear that she's been shook loose. From that mindset, shook loose from what's coming against her. Shook loose, God, that her family won't continue to move on her the way that they have been. But they're going to begin to bless her instead of her being a person have been taken advantage of. Today, God, I command a healing to take place in Sister Sandra Armstrong's mind in the name of Jesus. Father, look at Brother DJ O'Bannon, Father, over there where he is. God, begin to bless him, begin to protect him, begin to move on him like never before. Begin to strengthen him, God. Grow him up, Lord, even more. Help him to see things he's never seen before. Bless him, God, and do these things, God. I thank you for Brother DJ O'Bannon. Thank you for blessing him where he is, God, and doing the things that I know that he's capable of doing. In the name of Jesus, as he starts school, God, begin to strengthen him, begin to build him up. Let him play on the program that he needs to be, and let him be successful in the name of Jesus. Thank you for it, Father, in the name of Jesus. We give you the praise. Father, as we leave here, bind all mechanical things. Let no hurt, harm, or danger come to us, but keep us covered under your blood. God, thank you for the blessing. Thank you for the healing. Thank you for the financial blessing. Thank you for working it out for us. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Praise your name. Praise your name. Father, she told me last week, but I don't quite remember her name, so I'm going to say it like this. It's Sister Betty's daughter. Father, you brought her to my mind right now in the name of Jesus. And I'm asking you, God, to bless her right where she is. God, there's a door you said you're opening for her. And right now, God, open that door wide that she's able to walk through it. Sister Betty, he says favor is behind that door for her. Favor is behind that door. Favor is behind that door. Favor is behind that door, says the Lord, because I'm going to bless her. I'm going to raise her up. I'm going to strengthen her. I'm going to give her a mindset that she's never had before in the name of Jesus. She's going to call you and say, Mama, I think this way. Mama, I feel that way. And you're going to begin to raise your hands and say, thank you, God. What Pastor said has been confirmed in the name of Jesus. So thank you now, God, for what you've just done in the name of Jesus. Good God Almighty, good God Almighty. God, I'm trying to close. I'm trying to close. I'm trying to close. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Brother William, that was on the drums last week. Thank you, Lord, for Brother William. He said to save him, God. He asked you to save him. And because you saved him, Lord God, you're going to begin to put protective hedges around Brother William. And because of that, God, he wants to beat the drums. Put that beat in him now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Put that beat in him now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Put that beat in him now, Father, in the name of Jesus. That he will be able to hear. He'll be able to hear it, God, and beat it at the same time. In the name of Jesus. So thank you now for young Brother Williams. And I thank you, God, for blessing his parents, that he would recognize who God is enough to come and ask you to save him. So thank you, God, for what you've done with Brother Williams. I thank you now, Father. This and all other blessings we ask. Whew. Jesus, in the name we pray. Amen. And thank you, Jesus. Go in peace.